Anytime you feel like the need just to sit, please feel free to do so. So please do not feel obligated at all times to stand if you do not feel called to do that. We're especially blessed today to have two bishops of the two great traditions of Lutheranism and certainly Anglicanism. We're very honored to have Bishop Bud Cedarholm from the Diocese of the Episcopal Diocese of Massachusetts, as well as Bishop Jim Hazelwood from the New England Synod. So we are thrilled that they are here today with us, as well as all of this wonderful clergy that is with us. And most importantly, you that are with us. And I'm especially honored too today that the confirmation class that I share with Pastors Beatrice Michaels Brown and Pastor Sharon Hughes are joining me in greeting you today in a series of different languages. And so I'm thrilled that they are here, because they indeed are future, and we're glad that they are here. So please make sure you have a program, and I look forward to seeing you all at the reception afterwards.
Good afternoon. My name is Jean Caboni, and I'm the Vice President of the Congregational Council, and it is my honor, on behalf of the Council, to welcome you here today. And what a beautiful day it is. God is certainly smiling down on us as we celebrate this community service. And make sure you know, this is truly a community of faith that has existed in this place for 150 years. That's extraordinary. And it's as relevant today as it was 150 years ago. As Pastor Jeff said, we're very excited to have our religious leaders here with us today, our bishops, clergy from far and near, civic leaders, members of First Lutheran, people from the neighborhood, and friends. Please accept my heartfelt thanks and the thanks of the Congregational Council for being here and celebrating with us as we look back on our glorious and rich past, and we look forward to our glorious and bright future. Thank you.
At this time, we ask that the confirmation class of 2017 please come forward and greet us.
Welcome to First Lutheran 4th Anniversary.
Willkommen till First Lutheran Church für Ict Jubiläum.
Primo Quia Inglesia Evangelica Nulli Homini Alquinando Parcivat Anniversary Salvite.
Willkommen bei First Lutheran Church für Ict Jubiläum.
Kyrie kai eride. Kalos erfate stein prote Lutheranicae Ecclesia. Gietis epiteo.
Yoluban anyang hashimnika. Monjo rutawe peko ship junione o shingotok hwanyong hamnida.
Welcome to the First Lutheran Church for its 150th anniversary.
Please stand as you are able and join us in the singing of the hymn on page 10.
The Holy Gospel according to St. Luke, the 10th chapter.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Just then the lawyer stood up to test Jesus. Teacher, he said, what must I do to inherit eternal life? He said to him, what is written in the law? What do you read there? He answered, you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your mind, with all your soul, with all your strength, and your neighbor as yourself. And he said to him, you have given the right answer. Do this, and you will live. But wanting to justify himself, he asked Jesus, and who is my neighbor? Jesus replied, a man was going down from Jerusalem to Jericho and fell into the hands of robbers, who stripped him, beat him, and went away, leaving him half dead. Now by chance, a priest was going down that road, and when he saw him, he passed by on the other side. So likewise, a Levite, when he came to the place and saw him, passed by on the other side. But a Samaritan, while traveling, came near him, and when he saw him, he was moved with pity. And he went to him and bandaged his wounds, having poured oil and wine on them. And then he put him on his own animal, brought him to an inn, and took care of him. The next day he took out 2 denarii, gave them to the innkeeper, and said, take care of him, and when I come back, I will pay you whatever more you spend. Which of these three do you think was a neighbor to the man who fell into the hands of the robbers? And he said, the one who showed him mercy. Jesus said to him, go and do likewise. The Gospel of our Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Good afternoon, saints.
As a young
nice way of offering forgiveness. And I left, feeling the burden relieved. Forgiveness had been extended to me, except for over the years, I realized, I think she's wrong. I don't think it is the thought that counts. Because if it's just the thought, first of all, in this case, I don't even have the thought. That's one problem. But the thought that counts, there's no action involved. Today's reading, Parable Good Samaritan, is a reminder of our calling as Christians. Freed by Christ, grace abounds for all the traditions that are represented here. You don't have to be just Lutheran to get that one. Grace abounds, but the question is, what are we going to do in response to that grace? And the parable of the Good Samaritan, I think, is a wonderful parable because it talks about grace and mercy, but it also suggests some action. So here's why I want to acknowledge your past and point you to the future. I want you to pull out your bulletins. Go down to that first end of that first page. Look at verse 34, that's sentence number 34. What does it say there, those first three or four words? Can anybody read? Come on. Do we have the same book? What does it say? 34. Turn over. He where? He went to it. He went to it. Modern translation, he got off his donkey. Title of the sermon is Get Off Your Donkey. Thank you for coming. Here in Brockton, First Lutheran Church. Get off your donkey. He went to him. How do we know it's a donkey? Read on the next page. Because what does he do? He helps the man and he puts him back on his, it says animal. They did not have elephants that time in that part of the world. I want to extend a call to this congregation to get off its own. We live in a world that needs forgiveness. We live in a world that needs mercy. We live in a world that needs people who will offer the gifts of mercy to the community to be the problem. We need congregations that will help with healing ministries. We need congregations that will offer English as a second language. We need congregations that will engage their neighborhoods to make a difference for a hurting world. And here is the amazing thing. When congregations do that, the rest of the neighborhood notices. Because all of a sudden they start to say, hey, that's a church. And they actually are interested in our well-being. And what happens is all of a sudden the community turns to the church and is curious. And they start sticking their heads in the windows and the doors and poking around, and they look and see you engaging in ministry. These are exciting times and opportunities to be Christian. I know you've read all the studies. I know you've seen all the programs and talked about, you know, people aren't coming to church like they used to. That's true. But congregations that are interested in serving their neighborhoods, coming alive, the difference is, are you inward focused or externally focused? If you become an externally focused congregation, and I know, I've already heard the rumblings, you're moving in that direction. It's making some of you a little nervous, right? Three people nodded their heads. But that's the I know it makes you nervous because it's different. But it is the call that God is giving to the Church of Jesus Christ in this time. This day and age, we celebrate 150 years of First Lutheran Church in Brockton. We're going to go down and we're going to eat. I am told it is a monster buffet. I don't know what that means, but I'm looking forward. And then the question is, after the buffet, what are we going to do?
check up on you. You've been being here a lot. It's been great. I'm going to come back in a couple of years and I'm going to say, okay. Show me what you got. You up to it?
Yes.
Are you up to it?
Yes.
The congregation said amen.
Amen. Good afternoon. I'm Jim Benson, Parish Administrator, and I welcome all of you here this afternoon. And before we hear from our invited guests, we would also like to acknowledge the presence of certain people with us this day. First, it is an honor for us to have with us this day the eldest member of the congregation, Anna Pearson Haskins, who's sitting right here in the front row, who will be 99 in October, and she is here. We are thrilled that she is with us and able to be here. Another person that we wish to acknowledge, thinking that we have been here as a congregation for 150 years, we want to acknowledge somebody who has been part of this congregation for one-third of that time, and that is Hope Mahaffey, our organist emerita, who was organist for 52 years. We also have with us those who have served as pastor here, either as pastor or as interim. Over several years, we have Pastor Kenneth Hilston, we have Pastor Mark Peterson, interim Pastor Russell Norris, and interim Pastor Edward Sproul. And we also have with us now a member of First Lutheran, retired Lutheran pastor Kenneth Bjorklund, who did his internship here in the early 1950s. And glad to have Ken with us as a member and also as someone who is still a leader within the church. Welcome, Ken. And I'd also like to acknowledge that we have with us in the congregation today recently retired Pastor Jonathan Anquist of First in West Barnstable, whose father Hubert Anquist served as an interim pastor, intern here as well. So welcome to Pastor Anquist this day. And we want to also acknowledge the Reverend Carolyn Triggerstadt of Joy in Christ in Abington, Dean of the Southeastern Mass Conference of the New England Synod. Welcome. At this time, I would like to invite the Reverend James Hazelwood, Bishop of the New England Synod of the ELCA, to say a few more words following that great sermon. Bishop Hazelwood.
When I got the instructions for the worship service, it was very clear from your pastor. He emphasized you wanted a short sermon. I get here today and I'm to lengthen it. It's good to be here. I will go on because others have opportunities to speak. Congratulations on your 150th and many more. I'm grateful for your ministry in.
And we didn't provide any props for the bishop today like we did last Good Friday when he was here and there was a bat dive bombing him during the sermon. So that's why we held it in the afternoon in daylight. So. At this time, I would like to invite a good friend of the congregation to bring his greetings, the Right Reverend Bud Cederholm, retired suffragan bishop of the Episcopal Diocese of Massachusetts.
Good afternoon, church. I not only stand here to bring you greetings, but also on behalf of our bishops, Alan and Gail and Barbara, in the Episcopal Diocese of Massachusetts, I extend to you our best wishes, and for those of you who are Swedish, you'll get it, except I don't know the first word of the Swedish language. We Jag älskar dig. We, Yagalskadi, we love you. And we have been with you, Grace Chapel has been with you, 6 and a half of your 150 years. And so I know I stand here with Reverend Moses to extend to you how deeply gratified we are. In the words of your bishop, you were interested. You were interested in caring for us. You were interested in our well-being. You opened your hearts, your doors, your minds, and to us to come in. We had no home, did we? We had no home. And you welcomed us here. And I celebrate this day with you, as Reverend Moses does, as a part of your ministry and presence and witness to Brockton and beyond. So, Moses? Oh, I didn't. So we have something for some of you as a token of the diocese's love and thanksgiving for you in our lives. So I'm going to call Jeff, he's here, Jim Benson, Bishop Hazelwood, and Jean. If you could come here, we'd appreciate that. Now, Moses, as you know, loves hats. So here's a hat, Moses. And I love hats, so here's my hat. Now, these hats are the Episcopal Diocese of Massachusetts mission hat. It's got a very colorful, hopeful rainbow-colored cross on it. And it doesn't say Episcopal, so we're going to give you a hat as a token of our celebration with you, and gratitude to you in our common ministry together in Brockton. And I know the brigade celebrates this with you as well. So, okay. You can change the colors later if you want, if you like brown, green, or...
I'm going to give my card to the pastor, yeah.
All right. Okay.
For some reason, this hat, the predominant color is blue and yellow. At this time, I would like to invite forward to bring greetings from the Massachusetts State Senate, the Honorable Michael Brady, Senator of the 2nd Plymouth and Bristol Districts. Senator Brady.
Thank you for inviting me here to speak today and inviting me, and I'm very honored and privileged to be here. It's a great celebration to celebrate the 150th anniversary, and it brings back a lot of memories. Of course, I'm not 150 years old, but I love history, and I studied a lot of history, and this is a very important historic part of the city of Brockton, the south side here, and the many people of the Swedish descent who settled in this area of Brockton. And Brockton has a lot of great history and a lot of great things in our past, but we also know we can't live in the past. So we've got to take what we've learned from the past and celebrate the good things of the past, but move forward to keep this moving, the city and this Commonwealth moving forward. And working together, I think all of the people in this congregation and church and all of our friends at the state delegation and local city officials who work very well together. That's what helps us become the city of champions in the Commonwealth moving forward. And none of us do it alone. And I am very fortunate that in one of our magazines, U.S. News and World Report, named Massachusetts number one in the country in many great endeavors. And a lot of that great endeavor started right here in the city of Brockton with a lot of first initiatives. So we're very grateful for that. So I have a citation from the State Senate. Be it known that the Massachusetts Senate hereby extends its congratulations to the First Evangelical Lutheran Church of Brockton in recognition of the celebration of your 150 years of dedicated service and commitment to the residents of the greater Brockton area. And be it further known that the Massachusetts Senate extends its best wishes for continued success, that this citation be duly signed by the President of the Senate and attested to in a copy of the M4 transmitted by the Clerk of the Senate. So it's signed by President Stan Rosenberg, the Clerk William Walsh, myself Mike Brady, and I want to again wish you a great and honorable congratulations for 150 years of commitment to the City of Brockton. Thank you.
Next, I'd like to call to the podium representing the Massachusetts House of Representatives, the 9th Plymouth District, the Honorable Jerry Cassidy, State Representative.
First, when the Reverend was talking about the donkey, I thought it was going to be about the Democrats. That's when he, no. I just want to thank everybody. It's a wonderful occasion, 150 years. It's a wonderful. I see a lot of friends and neighbors, and you know, I say that neighbors, but my actual neighbor Gretchen, who's sitting up back, she lives right next to me. So, and when Jim Benson calls, you come running. I tell you, Jim is one of the hardest working men around, and I just want to give a shout out to Jim. He's one of the best guys that I know. My grandfather grew up right down the street. My father grew up on Riverview Street. And my grandfather used to be a policeman here in the city. And he always called this the Jewel of Campello, which truly is the jewel. I have a citation also from the House of Representatives. Be it hereby known that all the Massachusetts House of Representatives offers its sincerest congratulations to the First Lutheran Church in recognition of your 150th anniversary. May you have many more years of success, more than two. The entire membership extends its very best wishes and expresses the hope for future good fortunes and continued success in all endeavors. This day, the 23rd of 2017, signed by Rep. Claire Cronin, Michelle DeBar, and myself and the speaker. So congratulations and God love you.
Thank you. I don't know if His Honor the Mayor has arrived. I know he had several other events this afternoon. Hopefully he'll arrive at least to have some of the good food downstairs and to greet you. And I know that Council President Bob Sullivan was also, he is here. I see he got in. I know he had to register his sons for Little League today. And that's important, especially it's nice and sunny. And as we were beginning the procession, I heard the Red Sox were ahead. So, Councilor Sullivan, welcome.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Robert Sullivan, and I serve as the City Council President, and I've been a member of the Brockton City Council for the last 12 years. I'm here today in my capacity as the City Council President on behalf of the 11 members that serve proudly the city of Brockton to first of all, thank you. If you think about the First Lutheran Church and the membership, it's etched into the fabric of the history of this city. This city is known as the City of Champions. And being a proud Brocktonian, being born and raised in this city, I have to say that this church and its membership are the true champions in this city. And I echo the sentiments of the state representative. When Jim Benson calls, you come running. And I will say that Jim, in his capacity as an author, has captured so much of what Brockton has offered over the years. But 150 years is a true milestone. It's a jubilee. So on behalf of the Brockton City Council and as a Brockton guy, I just want to say thank you for what you do every day to better the City of Champions and continue. And here's to another 150 years. God bless you all. Thank you.
Thank you, Councillor. And I do want to also acknowledge that we do have in the congregation today another member of the City Council, Ann Borregat. Thank you for being here, Councillor, this afternoon. We're 150 years old. That makes us the second oldest entity in Campello. The only entity older than us in Campello is the Huntington School. They date back to about 1784. And it's great to be among the two oldest institutions that are active, that bring the community together, and we're honored to have with us, bringing greetings from the Huntington School principal, Mary Beth O'Brien. And as she comes forward, for those of you who don't know, earlier this, the end of last year, before Christmas, we had the Huntington School children, as part of the Campello Main Streets program, walked from the Huntington School here to First Lutheran, lighting the, or decorating the Christmas trees along the way. And when they arrived here, they came through those doors that were open, and Pastor Jeff was playing on full organ Jingle Bells. And I think to the kids of Huntington today, we are still the Jingle Bell Church. So I invite Principal O'Brien to bring greetings.
What an honor it is to be here today among such prestige. I wondered why, in fact, I was asked to come here today, having only 13 years at the Huntington, perhaps 120 for the school, but not so many for me. As the Huntington Elementary School, we have so many similarities with this church itself. Although we are celebrating our 120th Huntington School Parade, and I know many of you have marched in it, I've seen you. I hope you're back to march with us this year. We have a great memory between our two organizations. We preach, we teach, and we certainly do our best to empower those that walk through our hallways to continue the efforts and the civic pride that our two organizations stand so firm to continue. As you know, Campello is a wonderful community with such rich history, and much like the oak that stands at the very end of South Street and on the Huntington land, we'll remember that our strength and our commitment, our unwavering commitment to our community, and to continue to focus on the values and the history and the mission of our organizations, it's what's the utmost important. And although we may be the oldest institutions in the community, we are the most innovative in our practice. We continue to grow, we reflect on our history, and we continue to inspire to continue the great efforts of our Brockton City of Champions. Thank you all for being here. Thank you for having us here. And please continue to invest in the children of the Brockton Public Schools, as they are our future.
Don't believe His Honor has arrived, so we will continue the service with announcements from Pastor Jeff.
Welcome once again. We're so glad that you are here, and it's such an honor to be a part of such an event. As many of you know, I am not from New England. I'm indeed from the South. I'm from below the Mason-Dixon line. And so I feel especially honored to be in your presence today, as well as my great colleagues here. I'm so honored, these bishops here, and my great friend and colleague, Father Moses Suale from Grace Chapel, and my colleagues right here. I'm so honored. Many thanks to so many people who have made this event so possible. David Burnham, our organist and choir master, the choir itself. Our amazing confirmands and able to get up there and do the thing they did in front of us all, and my partners in theological education, Pastor Sharon and Pastor Beatrice, thank you so much. Thank you, confirmands. Many thanks to all the blessed people who have made today happen, and as well as the wonderful event that you're about to participate in downstairs in the vestry following this service. Please join us. It's an extraordinary meal. It indeed is a monster meal. That was my adjective. But also what's extraordinary are there many historical displays for you to gaze upon, and they'll be up even throughout the week until next week. Next Sunday morning at 10 a.m. we have the actual 150th to the day celebration at 10 a.m. and we have a great brass ensemble from Chicago joining us, the Alliance Brass, as well as my personal friend and colleague Sarah Pillow, who's coming from New York to sing some Bach for us. And so we have an extraordinary musical service and more celebration in that sense. So please come back next Sunday at 10 a.m. And yes, indeed, Bishop, I agree with you. We are getting off of our donkey and trying to figure that out. And I have the same questions that he does. What happens in year 151? And what happens in year 501 of the Reformation celebration? So I ask those same questions to myself. So I'm indeed honored and inspired by what you had to say. So one last announcement. We don't have an actual formal offertory today, so we would like, if you do feel called to leave us any sort of gift today, there are stations at the doors with offering plates in them. You do find an offering envelope in your service leaflet that's a part of your bulletin. And finally, I hope everyone got a commemorative book. Everyone got a commemorative book, so please nod if you got a commemorative book. And the person who created this commemorative book has disappeared, of course, because he went into the sacristy. But I have to thank Jim Benson, and like so many people have said this morning, if Jim calls, I come a-running. And Jim created this extraordinary book that you have that celebrates certainly the past and the present, and I hope celebrates the future. So with that, I want to thank Jim for all his hard work and all the blessings that he brings to this place. So once again, please join us downstairs. I look forward to saying hello to each and every one of you. And many thanks to our great chefs who prepared this wonderful, wonderful feast. With that being said, please stand as you're able. Bishop Hazelwood is going to deliver the final blessing.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, bless and preserve us.
Amen. Please join us in the singing of our final hymn, our sending hymn on page 11, Praise to the Lord Almighty.